In this illustration, we'll be studying about oscillations of a charge at the center of a square. Here we are given that equal charges plus Q are fixed at four corners of a square of side root 2a. And a fifth charge of equal magnitude and mass m is placed at the center of a square which is free to move. We are required to show that it is in a stable equilibrium, and we are called to find the period of small oscillations of the charge along the diagonals of a square. Here, to understand the situation, let's first draw the picture. And if this is the situation at which there are four charges which are given to be in fixed state at the corners of a square, and one charge is placed which is free to move and having mass m at the center of this square. And obviously, as the charges are symmetrically placed, the net electric field at the center of a square due to all these charges is zero. So net force on the central charge will also be zero. Now let's displace it by a distance x along one diagonal. Say we displace it by a distance x over here. Then you can see on this charge, this plus Q will exert a force in this direction. Symmetrically, this plus Q will also repel it in this direction. And here we can consider if this angle is theta, this theta, then the force acting on the charge away from the center point is 2F cos theta if these forces are F. And if we talk about this plus Q and this plus Q, they will also be exerting the force, where the force of this plus Q is more on a repulsive force because it is closer to it. Now we can calculate these forces, and net force acting on the block will impart a restoring acceleration to this block. So here we can write one force acting on it is F1, which is the resultant of these two, and another force is in this direction, which we can call F2, which is due to these two charges. So let's write down the equation of motion. Then we can write at displacement, x from O, we can write F2 minus F1 is equals to MA1. If A1 is the acceleration of this particle with which it is coming back. Now here we can write it MA1 is equals to F2 minus F1, and the values of F2 and F1 we can substitute. F2 is the resulting force of these two charges as we discussed. So here we can first write the value of F2 as force due to this minus force due to this. So F2 we can write as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square divided by, if we talk about the edge length of the square, it is given as root 2a. That means the half diagonal length is a. So the value will be a minus x whole square. So this will be the force due to this plus Q acting onto this mass. And if we calculate the force due to this plus Q, so we can write it minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by A plus X square minus F1 is the force due to these two charges. So it will be 2F cos theta. So it can be written as 2. The force acting on it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by, this distance will be A square plus X square, under root whole square. And if we substitute the value of cos theta, that will be multiplied with x divided by root of a square plus x square. Here you can see this is the value of 2f cos theta. That's what we have calculated. And further, if we simplify this, here you can see the value of acceleration we can see we are getting. We can take this q square by 4 pi epsilon naught m common. So this will be q square divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. This mass we can take on the other side. And in the whole expression, we can also take a square common out, and in that situation you can see the first term will be getting 1 by a square 1 minus x by a whole square, minus in this expression it is 1 by a square 1 plus x by a whole square, and minus in this expression you can see in numerator it is 2x divided by, here we can ignore the term of x square because x is very small compared to a, as we need to find the time period of a small oscillations. So this can be written as a square plus x square to power 3 by 2. So this will be a square to power 3 by 2. Here I am using a is very large compared to x, or x is very small. And in this expression, if we take this a square common out, so the value of acceleration we are getting is q square by 4 pi epsilon naught m a square. And here we are getting this 1 minus x by a whole square, which can be written as 1 minus x by a to power minus 2. And this again minus 1 plus x by a to whole power minus 2. And the term here after taking a square common out will be minus 2x by a. And further simplifying this, here you can see this can be taken as 1 plus x by a. We can use the binomial expansion for 1 plus x to power n is approximately 1 plus nx if x is very small compared to 1. So the same expression we use here, the value of a1 we are getting is q square by 4 pi epsilon naught m a square, and this 1 plus 2x by a minus 1, and this will be minus 2x by a, so this will be plus 2x by a minus 2x by a, so these two terms gets cancelled out, 1 also gets cancelled out. So the final value of acceleration we are getting, you can see this is a proportional function of x, which implies that the particle will be executing SHM. We can also put a negative sign as acceleration is opposite to displacement. So this can be given as q square by, and this 2 also gets cancelled out, this 2 pi epsilon naught m a square, this will become a cube multiplied by x. Here you can write negative sign included as a is opposite to x. For proving SHM we are doing it, and we can compare it with a is equals to minus omega square x. From here we get the value of angular frequency of SHM is equals to root of q square by 2 pi epsilon naught a cube m, which gives a further value of time period, which is 2 pi by omega, and the final result here is 2 pi by q under the root 2 pi epsilon naught a cube m. That is the final result of this problem.